Welcome to the Richard Brunelle Performance Hall. Before the performance begins, please take a moment to locate your nearest emergency exit and silence your cell phones. Thank you, and please enjoy the show. Supposed to stand up in a little bit when I walk out to conduct. But good job, guys. All right, good evening. I'm Mr. Brucker, as you know. It is my absolute pleasure to welcome you here this evening. And can you believe it's the end of the year? I'd like to introduce our MC, School Board Trustee Sheila Allen. She's a huge music supporter, huge activist in the community with helping to do as much as possible to support the schools, and we're very, very excited and very honored by her being here and her support of the music program in town and all the work that she's done to help keep us going all these years. So may I present Sheila Allen.
It's my dream come true to have those little feet pounding for me. I never had that before. Thank you for that. Yes, it is Sheila Allen, a huge music supporter. I'm so glad to be here this evening. Welcome to the Emerson Da Vinci Harper Junior High Orchestral Spring Concert. It is really great to be here. Honestly, I can't believe, but can you believe this? How many days are left in school? 12 days of school left. Can you believe it? I thought they'd say that faster. It comes right off the tongue of my kids. So only 12 days of school left. No more full weeks of school, not even one. So we are almost there. But make sure you go all the way to the end, right? We have to keep working all the way to the end. Don't give up. So it seems like just yesterday that the school year began. And we were looking forward to the potential of what a great new year can bring. And here we are at the end in time for our final concert and the celebration of all that these students have learned. How many of you went to the concerts when they were in fifth and sixth grade? Raise your hand. Anybody? Okay, and now you are so amazed what happens when they have the opportunity to play music 5 days a week. Isn't that a fabulous thing, what happens? So we have a great music program in our district. I am so very proud of it. I'm particularly proud of the growth and strengthening of the orchestra program. I'm so very proud of them and of all the parents that support it. So I'm really pleased to be here tonight as your MC. So they already told you to shut your cell phones off, right? Yes, okay, good, don't forget to do that. All right, so first up this evening before you is the Emerson-Harper Junior High Intermediate Orchestra. This group involves students from Emerson, Da Vinci, and Harper, and it's wonderful to see them all work together for the first time in collaboration to create some great music. The seventh graders have had a great year together making music, making friends, and having a really good time. I heard them warming up beforehand, and they are having a really good time together. Just recently, the Intermediate Orchestra attended the Music in Parts Festival, and not only did they win their part of the competition and receive a unanimous superior rating, but they won the whole competition. So this is the second year in a row that our seventh graders in attendance and won the Music in the Parts competition. That's so great. And if you would like to see the bling that they brought home, the trophies are in the lobby. You can see that now afterwards. So congratulations on that. Okay, now on with the show. Let's welcome the Emerson-Harper Junior High Intermediate Orchestra, conducted by the ever-enthusiastic Greg Brucker and led by concertmasters Autumn Marqueski and Taylor Trinidad. Welcome in, please.
Thank you.
thanks a lot. If you can tell my voice, last few weeks of good hard work has taken its toll. It's been a really, really great years for these guys. I mean, from day one, I knew there was something special about this class, and I'll tell you, these guys are rock stars. I am so impressed with what they've been able to do and how hard they've worked. They have amazing attitudes. They love it, and I think it's awesome. And you know, I've been getting very reflective this last week, you know, on the year and all that. And can you believe these guys? I mean, remember last year you had the big Army concert with Ms. Cole and the 500 kids on the floor, and seeing where they were then, and they're doing phenomenal in the elementaries. But then a year later when they get into class every single day, how cool, what a difference. I mean, a big, big difference, you know? It's amazing what they can do in a half an hour a week, and once we get them here, they just take right off. And it's absolutely wonderful. These guys are the future of the program right here. I'm real proud of them. Just give them another huge applause. That I would embarrass them a little bit, so if you saw their faces, I think it worked. So, we just played a couple tunes we've been working on for a while. We presented them a couple times. We won the competition with those. And we got two big new ones to debut for you guys tonight as our end of year final music. So, before we start, there's one thing I want to do. We've got two eighth graders here who have been helping out a whole lot, or eighth grader, ninth grader, forgive me, Patrick, that have been helping out a whole lot, coming out and doing rehearsals, playing bass with these guys, and helping out Esteban, as he's the only bass player back there in the seventh grade, who's doing great. And so Patrick and Alex, thank you guys very, very much for sticking out with me. So thank you guys so much.
students are still up here. First of all, this program is a thing of beauty. I don't know if the person who made these is out in the audience, but thank you to whoever designed this. But if you would take a moment when the lights are up to look at all of the wonderful supporters of your orchestra program, it's really quite impressive. And maybe when you're downtown or out and about and you see some of these local organizations, why don't you thank them for supporting our music program? Because it's really a wonderful thing. It does indeed take a whole village to make a wonderful orchestra like this. Maybe you guys should thank them too. A couple of things before we go to intermission. So this is my 8th year on the school board. It seems like you guys were you were younger when I started. And it's been, Greg mentioned, I am a huge supporter of the music program. I've never been in an orchestra, but I was a band person from fourth grade all the way through college, and I find that my way now of giving back to the music program is through things like being on the school board and being supportive of the music program. And I've been running around telling other people, so I'll tell you publicly here, that not this November, but the following November is election, and I've decided that I'm not going to run again. But I want you guys, so that gives you a long time to think about it. So take a moment and think about it, because I'm really looking for someone in the community who really cares deeply about the schools, has kids in the schools, and would like to see wonderful programs like this carry on. So I think you don't have to decide tonight, but if you want to talk to me about it, give me a call. I'm in the phone book, or email me, because I would really love to see some strong music supporters in the mix when there's the election year from November, so think about that for a moment. So now, before admission, I have a couple announcements. First, we need to give a great big thank you to the DeSoma and orchestra boosters and volunteers. Are there any of the board members in the audience? Would you please stand and smile and wave at us? Stand up if you're a DeSoma board member. There has to be at least one member of the board. They are a force to be reckoned with. That DeSoma group does a great job of fun, not only fundraising, but organizing the trips that you take and all the great things that happen for the band. So thank you very, very much to them. Not just the DeSoma board members, but all of you parents out there who make sure that the violins are forgotten, get to school, and that the strings are replaced, and that when they forgot the bow tie or whatever they're wearing, that all those things that it takes to be an orchestra parent happen. So thank you very much. Give yourself a round of applause, you parents out there. Next, if you would like to see this one more time or 10 more times, they're videotaping it right now, and CDs and DVDs are available. But the deadline for getting the order for the CD or DVDs is tonight. So during intermission or at the end of tonight, there's a DeSoma table out there. Make sure you stop by and get yours when you're hot. So finally, there are goodies and drinks that have been provided by some of the wonderful parents and families. They've donated them. So we will now break for a 15-minute intermission.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone. Did you have a nice break? Well, while they're getting settled in, I have a question for you. Did any of you have an opportunity to attend the Wenberg concert? I have a little story that I want to share with the audience, but also with the students on the stage here. By the way, students still, okay, there you go, getting one more chair. So at the Wenberg concert, I had the absolute joy of bringing along a dear friend of mine, Dr. Herbert Bauer, who at your concert was 103 years old. Can you imagine that? So we had the wonderful opportunity of sitting front and center. And when he was a small boy in Vienna, he played violin and he loved classical music. So your concert brought him great, great joy. And he, I don't know, did your group play a Mozart? Mozart is his favorite. So he had a chance to enjoy your music, and he has been to multiple Davis High and Junior High music programs. And I want you to think about that when you're 103, I hope you still are enjoying the music that you are playing today. So Herb and I enjoyed the beautiful concert, and after the concert he said that this is probably my last concert because he wasn't feeling so very well. And we listened to the concert and we went and got ice cream like you're supposed to after a concert and drove around in the countryside and watched the sunset, and then he died just a couple of weeks after that. So I wanted to thank you for providing a wonderful, very last concert for a very special man. So let's say thank you. Okay, on a happy note. So this band here, this is the third year of the Emerson-Harper Orchestra program, and I'm very proud to say that they attend competitions in the Bay Area, and they not only attend them, but they win them. So they go and they win the whole thing. They've been to Santa Cruz to compete, and they received a unanimous superior rating, and then they scored so many points that they had the most points of any group there, right? That's what you got? Congratulations. But that's not all. I have been informed that I have the opportunity to give you an exciting announcement about this advanced orchestra. They have been chosen to be one of only 10 groups that get to perform in a brand new state level festival open only to the very best groups in the state. So they are going to be a part of the first ever California Music Educator Association All-State Band and Orchestra Festival this Thursday. So congratulations. Fabulous. And I want to tell you just a couple that I've been provided with a few statistics here, and this is something that we should be excited about. So the orchestra program, as I've mentioned, has been really growing in quality and in numbers, so that this group here, the students that are in Emerson, DaVinci, Harper, has grown from 70 students just 2 years ago to over 100 now. And Mr. Brucker has let me know that next year, believe it or not, it's his 10th year here in the district. Isn't that amazing? We should congratulate him. Next year, we're going to have approximately 70 incoming 7th graders and 110 8th and 9th graders that he'll be teaching. So that is just amazing. So next year, there's going to be at, that's at Emerson at Harper. When he first started, there were only 22 students in orchestra. And next year, there's going to be 90 there. So, yay, that's fabulous. Very, as Mr. Barker says right here, very cool. Does he ever say that in class? Yeah. You know, he's actually a Southern California boy, a surfer, so we excuse him for that. Okay, so we are so very proud of this music, the music program that we have here in Davis, so it would be best if we would carry on with the music program. So please join me in welcoming the Emerson Harper Junior High Advanced Orchestra, conducted by Greg Brucker and led by our concert masters, Miguel Soler and Sehej Bajwa.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, everybody. These are the two tunes we did at the competition. I guess it was just a week ago. It feels like eons ago already. But those are the two we did at the competition, which won the competition. They've been working on those real hard, and they sound awesome. We're going to be taking both those pieces to the All-State Fest this week. We'll also be taking the piece we play right after I talk for a few minutes as well. So we're real excited about that. It's a very, very cool thing. So, as I said, amazingly, here we are. It's almost the end of May. It's unbelievable how fast the year goes, you know? And it just seemed like yesterday we were starting up. Things going down. We were starting up and, you know, getting a fresh start on the school year, looking at some new music, and kind of wondering what the year would hold for us. And it's really been a phenomenal year. These guys have worked so hard. And I mean, you can just tell with not just how well they play, but you can see it when they're playing. They love it. They're really into it. And I'm really, really proud of these guys for that. It's a wonderful group. And yeah, I'm really proud of these guys. So, this is one of the fun times of year where at the same time we get to highlight all of our wonderful ninth graders. It's also sad that we have to lose them to bigger and better places. These are students that have been with us some 1 year, who've come over from different schools, some 2 years, some 3 years, and I'm gonna miss all you guys. It's been a really wonderful ninth grade class. You guys are really something else. I'm real, real proud of you guys. So, I'm gonna list them off by school here, and have you guys stand up, and we'll try to hold our applause to the end, and then we'll get everybody together. So, we'll start with the Emerson and DaVinci students. Here we go. Chitrika, who are you? Right there. Oh, yeah, we'll keep a hold on. Let's see, Tanner. And Mickey. Theo, unfortunately, is sick tonight. He's in the bass section, so we can imagine another bass player back there. Aiden, Robbie, Jada, Emily, Annapurna, Dante, Frank, Isaac, Ben, Miguel, Hannah, David, Bay, Catherine, Marissa, and Jimmy. Those are our Emerson DaVinci ninth graders. First, Andrew on the bass back there. We have Sahej, Anna, Patrick on the bass, Arnon, Kate, Casey, and Kathy. We have Josina, we have Tanner, we have Bhavna, Miranda and Helena, Raven, Andrew on the cello, Brandon, Helen, Mari, Olivia, Andrea, Shreya, Walter, and Madeline, the Harper ninth graders. It's a really phenomenal class. They are the first of the large classes that we've had and enjoyed over the last few years. Numbers have been growing and growing, and we have another 30 plus set of classes coming in next year, and this ninth grade group was the first one. So it's a big group to go, and you guys are gonna have some really great experiences at DaVinci and at Davis High here. And I really, really wish you all the best in everything you guys do. You've really done a wonderful job here the last few years, and gonna miss you guys tremendously. So congratulations to you. Okay, now, we have some parents to thank because we've had parents who've been helping us out doing some of the behind the scenes work for us for several years now. We've got some ninth grade leaving parents, and we're grateful, beyond grateful, for their help, and very sad to see them move on, even though we know they'll be doing bigger and better things as well at the high school year. So, first of all, before we get into our ninth grade parents, we have one senior DeSoma member, senior being senior student DeSoma members, forgive me for that, and she's been our treasurer for several years, and she's been an amazing support. Her student was an Emerson student some years back, and I think she's still back there. So we're very sad to lose her as our treasurer. She's left a wonderful legacy of really great work for us. So Jean Criddle, will you please come up? Are you here? There you go. Getting things going, I want to give them a big thank you. So, we have Lori and we have Marlo. If you'll both come out, I think they're backstage somewhere, probably trying to hide. There you go. I think I enjoy that more than they do back there. we also have, we've had these amazing programs over the years, and we found a wonderful parent who does graphic design, and these things have just been beautiful over the last several years. So, let's see, Andrew Johnson, are you out there? Come on up. Let's acknowledge Andrew's beautiful program. She's done this all the way for us. Students in the program. One of them we get to keep for one more year, fortunately, but one of them is a ninth grade parent, and her son is moving on. It's the last one. So, Cindy Hughes, if you can come up. Are you out here? Are you back? She's in the lobby. Let's get her. Is she out here? Cindy? I think she's in the lobby, hanging out. Does anyone want to pop back there and see if we get her? Oh, you guys sit there. You guys have plenty of energy, I know. Let's see here. We need some like music. Cindy, there we go. Come on down. Thank you so much for all of your work for this session. You've been amazing. And I really, truly could not be more grateful to them all. So let's call them all but once. We have Jennifer Bavetta, Bubbly Bajwa, and Shelley Porterfield. Come on. Let's see if they'll come on. Come on. Come on. To support us in the many ways, between being there at events for chaperoning and donations to help us get on field trips, and being around at some of our events, and as well, I mean, most importantly, you guys are clearly supporting them phenomenally. We have these amazing musicians. They have supportive families to help completely promote their musicianship and their interest, and I mean, we couldn't ask for anything more. And then on top of that, we, in the last 14 months, repassed all the parcel taxes that allow for this program to continue, and that's because of you guys. And it's been quite a year, you know, and I can't thank you all enough for what you have done for this community, for this district, for these kids. It really is, I'm truly indebted to this community for what you guys have done. So I want to thank you all for that. Before we get going on to our last couple things, we have just a couple more students I want to have stand up and recognize who have become our crew leaders this year. And if you notice them kind of popping on and off stage and all that, they're doing a phenomenal job getting this thing done. I don't even have to help anymore. I can just kind of watch and do it. It's wonderful. And so what do we have? Actually, I found out that there's someone in a recent couple weeks has been helping out all sorts of times. He totally did it under the radar, and I'm really impressed. So, first of all, we have to acknowledge the ninth grader, which is Walter right there. Thank you for your help, Walter. And also, we have Daniel and Katrina, who have been doing a great job. These guys have really taken on this thing on their own and made it happen, and they're always some of the first ones in and the last ones out. You know, I'm real appreciative of the fact that they're into it. They've done a great job. Well, let's get on the show. Here's the last few tunes. Hello, everybody. My name is Miguel, and I've been with Mr. Brucker for 3 years now, and every day has been a great experience, a new adventure, learning new music and meeting new friends through music. And Mr. Brucker has been a great mentor and teacher, and I've improved as a musician and as a person. So thank you, Mr. Brucker. Jupiter and Dance Macabre and the Largo, and see how we do. This fest is a pretty big deal, and you know, there's very few groups that can be considered an all-state group. It's the first time they've had this festival, and we're one of them. They're one of two orchestras in the state that's performing. There's eight bands, that's it. And congratulations to you guys. First, because the podcast is closing these, but I want to say thank you to Sheila as well. And thank you, Sheila.
Well, when we talk about supporters of the music program and Greg, and he's new at this, I think that he might have forgotten to thank his beautiful new wife, Laura. So thank you to the support program.